Welcome to Harvest Kids!
Hey, Mr. Mike. Yeah. I have a present for you.
What?
Yeah, it's some of Isaac's world famous cookies.
You shouldn't have. It's my favorite.
Yeah, enjoy.
Cookies. Wow, can you believe it? Brussels sprouts? Come back here.
Ooh.
Hey, Isaac.
Hey. What is this?
It's a balloon for you.
Oh, that's so sweet of you.
Yeah.
Sorry about those cookies.
Oh, that's okay. I forgive you. I just wanted to give you this.
Thanks.
Who's there? You got the balloon.
Okay, so Isaac, I have this really important message letter for you. You might want to open it as fast as you can.
I don't know, Mr. Mike. Oh, it just says prank.
Good one,
Mr. Mike. I know, we've been pranking each other all for fun. You know, because we're talking about Jacob and Esau and how Jacob played a trick on his brother. We're gonna hear more about that in our Bible story today, but we have other stuff to do too. We are gonna do a snack. We are gonna play a game. We are going to have the Bible story and we're gonna do some worship, and it starts with worship right now. So wherever you're at, stand up to your feet. That's right, this isn't a prank.
No, this is the real deal.
Never when worshiping God. So stand up and let's get worshiping now.
Woo!
Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave, life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. Face to face, I am yours, Jesus, you are mine. Endless joy, perfect peace, earthly pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. Yeah, he's alive.
Happy day, happy Welcome to our Focus Up moment. I've actually brought some friends with me to help us, and we are just going to come set ourselves aside and settle our hearts, and we are going to worship Jesus together. And we are talking about joy, and it's an old song that everybody probably knows, so my friends are just going to help us, and come join us. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. I got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to say, and I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart, and I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. Thank you for joining us for this Focus Up moment.
Hey kids, welcome to our game today. It's called
Name That Oreo.
We are gonna have different Oreos placed in front of us, and then we're gonna have to taste them. This is my favorite game because I love Oreos.
I love Oreos, but I always take it out and just,
oh, you do?
Filling only.
Oh, well, you could do that, but you have to guess the flavor. Now kids, this is how you play with us. We're gonna both guess on what the flavor is, and you have to choose which one's gonna be right, Mr. Mike or Mr. Isaac. So that's how you can play the game with us. So let's go ahead with the first Oreo. All right, let's get our Oreo. Okay. Okay.
I think I already know.
Man, I don't know if I'm going to be good at this game.
Well, it's definitely good.
Maybe let's say our guess is on 3, 2, 1.
Birthday
caramel.
Cake.
You were right. It's birthday cake.
Whoa!
So Isaac won this round and I lost because all I could really taste was caramel, and I've never eaten a caramel Oreo, but... All right.
Winner gets to finish it?
Sure. Can loser finish it too?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go. I'm going to get home right now. Okay.
Come again?
All right, we got our second Oreo in front of us. Ready? Smell test.
Ooh.
What is that?
That is strong.
Okay.
Pretty.
Eat it.
Well, I had one idea, now it's definitely a different one.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Coffee.
Java chip coffee. We both got it right.
Boom!
All right, so everyone wins.
Yay!
All right, let's get our next cookie flavor in front of us now. Okay, we have our next cookie in front of us. Ready? Next cookie. I got no flavors here.
Ready to guess?
No.
Oh, you need another bite?
Mm-hmm. I don't know why I can't taste the flavor.
Maybe that's a hint.
I'm gonna guess.
1, 2, 3, classic.
Red velvet.
Oh.
Oh, golden vanilla.
Oh.
There was like no flavor there unless it was vanilla.
Yeah.
I was just taking a shot in the dark, so we both got it wrong.
Boom, boom, boom.
All right, let's get our next cookie now. And go ahead.
Sniff test.
Oh.
Ooh, that's distinct.
This is my favorite. Uh-huh.
I know. Wait, you already know what it is? Oh wait, I think I know what it is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Undeniable.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Who do you think's gonna get it right? Both of us or just one of us? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Mint.
It is mint.
Boom.
Yeah, yeah.
You can't miss the mint flavor.
All right.
It's so distinct.
This is a good one. All right, we got our next cookie in front of us. Ready for it, Isaac? Here we go.
Ooh.
It smells like holiday-y.
Oh, I think I know what it is.
I cannot place it. You might win this one.
Yeah. I know what it is, but I have to like, okay, I think I know what it is. But kids, you think I'm gonna get it right? Or I already gave it away. I think I know it. Ready? 3, 2, 1.
Graham
Teddy
cracker?
Graham crackers. Pumpkin spice. I think we were close, but we both got it wrong. So I was thinking pumpkin, but then I thought it was the Teddy Grahams that I was eating.
It did,
you know?
Didn't it? Yeah, the cookie must be flavored like that.
Isaac, this is our last cookie.
Final cookie.
Are you ready?
Final cookie. Let's
do it. All right, here we go.
I think I have a hint right now.
3, 2, 1.
Double stuffed.
Marshmallow.
Oh, look at you. Double stuffed. No, mega stuffed. You win that one.
Mega stuffed.
Yeah. I thought it was marshmallow. I guess every Oreo is a marshmallow.
I mean, it does look like there was a massive marshmallow
this
stuffed in between the crackers.
Too much stuffing, and I'm going to eat.
Or it's just enough. Remember what I said? I love all the stuffing.
Well, thanks for playing our game with us today. Who won? You won.
We both did.
Good job. Because when you eat Oreos, you both win.
That's right.
But I need some milk. So let's go get some milk. Thanks for playing our game today. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Hey kids, and welcome back to another Unboxing the Bible. It's one of my favorite parts of the episode. Today's word is P-L-A-N-S, plans. And today's word comes from Proverbs 19:21. It says, many are the plans in a person's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails. Now you say it with me. Many are the plans in a person's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails. Proverbs 19:21. Well, thanks so much for unboxing the Bible with me today. We'll see you next time.
Bye. Hey kids, welcome to our Bible story today. It's about Jacob and Esau. My name is Esau. Check the hair on my arms. I'm Esau. I'm just kidding. That is what happened in our Bible story today, though. Jacob tricked his dad, Isaac, into thinking he was Esau, and we're going to get into that. But right now, we are in the book of Genesis, and there are three big names of men who led families in Genesis: Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? And we are talking about Isaac. So Isaac had two sons, Jacob and Esau, and they were born one right after another, and Esau comes out first. So he has the birthright, which means he gets the best inheritance lands, he gets most of the money for the inheritance, and it was a big deal being the firstborn son. So that went to Esau. Now, Rebekah was Jacob's mother, and Rebekah loved Jacob very much. And Isaac, the dad, he loved Esau because he would go out and hunt and bring food in for the family. So he was a manly man. And what happened was, is Isaac knew he was going to die. He was really old. So he was starting to get things in order. Esau would go hunt, bring back food. And one time, Esau went out and he was so hungry when he got back. And Jacob had some food going on the stove. And Esau says, I'm so hungry, I'm gonna die. Give me some of that food. And Jacob says, why don't you sell me your birthright for that food? Now, was this right of him to do? No, because God had appointed Esau as the firstborn, but Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of stew. He was so hungry, he thought he was gonna die. So that's where this whole birthright changing of hands. So now he needs to go and get affirmed by his dad, but he doesn't, you know, he needs to wait. When's the right time? So Rebekah, his mom, loved him very much and heard Isaac, the dad, say, Esau, I'm getting old and I'm blind and I want some food before I die. So go out and hunt and bring back some food. So that's just what he did. He went out to go hunting. And this was a time for Rebekah to say, Jacob, Esau's away. Go in and get the birthright from your dad, the one that you bought from Esau for one bowl of stew. So he covers his arms with animal's hair, Rebekah does, and puts hair on his neck and puts him in Esau's clothes and sends him in. And the blind dad, Isaac, is like, is that you, Esau? And he goes, yes, it is me, Dad. And that was Jacob, right? I don't know how he got away with that voice. The old man must have been hard of hearing, but he goes in with some really good food that Rebekah made him, and he presents it to Isaac. And Isaac puts his hands on him and says, I give you the birthright and I bless you. And so that's what happened. Now, before Jacob was even born, Rebekah was told that her son would be blessed, that Jacob would be a blessed man. That was gonna come true in God's way. But guess what? Rebekah kind of pushed her son Jacob into getting this birthright. And so it kind of messed things up, but God brought it good, even though there were things that were meant for bad, like stealing the birthright. And that kind of reminds me of Joseph's story, which is at the end of Genesis. And at the end of Joseph's story, his brothers are kneeling down saying, Joseph, you know, we are your servants, after they sold him into slavery. And Joseph says these words. It's in Genesis chapter 50, verse 20, and it says, as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good in order to bring about it is this day to save many people. So even Joseph says, you know what? You meant for evil and God turned it around for good. And that's what happened with Jacob's story. And God can do that in our stories too. He can turn our terrible situations into situations that are blessed by God. But we do have to follow him and we do have to continue to seek after him. And you know what? There is a Bible verse. It's John 10:10, part two. And it says, I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. Some translations say to the fullest. So Jesus came that we might have abundant life, a full life, but we need to be patient and trust that God has good things for us. So thank you for joining me in Jacob and Esau's story today. And we'll see you next time for another Bible lesson, but that's all for now. Bye-bye.
Hey friends, Jackie here, and welcome to Snacky Time. Today we are making something really cool. You think it's one thing, but it's actually another. So we are gonna make pretzel flowers. Isn't that cute? Okay, so this is really easy. All you need are M&Ms, pretzels, and something to hold them together. Today I'm using melted white chocolate, but you could use peanut butter or even frosting would work. I'm gonna actually dump out my M&Ms on a clean surface, and I'm gonna sort them a little. So I'm gonna make a blue flower first. So what you wanna do is put like five or six M&Ms together of the same color. And then we're gonna take our pretzel and we're going to put a little bit of melty chocolate on it. You don't need to do too much because of course the M&Ms are gonna be sweet all by themselves. All right, and then wipe off the excess and you're gonna put it on your plate and then you're gonna arrange, first you can start with your center of your flower and then you can arrange all of your other M&Ms around it. Ta-da, let's make a few more. Ta-da! So these are a little bit messy from the white chocolate, but they're so cute. Are we gonna put them in the refrigerator? The chocolate will harden, the M&Ms will stick to the top of the pretzel, and then you have a delicious flour pretzel snack. Well, if you make these, take a picture, tag us on Harvest Kids Live so we can see your pretzel flour creations. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Hey, Mr. Mike, today's lesson was so great, and the story. I learned so much about Jacob and Esau that I didn't know before.
Yeah, you know, Jacob really jumped the gun in his pranks with his brother Esau. But if he just would have waited, God's promise would have come true anyways, but he wanted to do things himself, and he kind of messed it up. So our encouragement to you kids is wait on the Lord, because the Lord has good promises for you. So listen, thanks for joining us today. If you'd like to see more episodes like this, you can find us online at YouTube and Instagram at Harvest Kids Live. So we'll see you next time.
Oh, Mr. Mike, just as a truce, because I know we were playing a lot of pranks back and forth, I decided to actually get you real cookies. Oh. I promise they are real cookies this time.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna, yeah, you know, I think I like Oreos and he knows that, so I think this is a long overdue. Isaac!
Oh, sorry. Oh, that one's for me. Thanks.
Oh. that was a Brussels sprout, but I'm gonna go ahead and eat these Oreos and let Isaac take the vegetables. We'll see you next time. Bye.